हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम दर्शना पटेल फ्रॉम वीपीएमपी पॉलिटेक्निक। माय सब्जेक्ट नेम इज मोबाइल कंप्यूटिंग एंड एप्लीकेशन डेवलपमेंट। यूनिट नेम टोस्ट मेनू डायलॉग लिस्ट एंड एडेप्टर एंड द टॉपिक नेम इज मेनू डायलॉग एंड टोस्ट। नाउ ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ टूडेज लर्निंग इज टू अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑप्शन मेनू, एलर्ट डायलॉग बॉक्स, टोस्ट एंड टोस्ट कस्टमाइजेशन इन एंड्रॉयड। नाउ टॉपिक्स टू बी कवर्ड इन दिस वीडियो इट्स मेनू and specifically option menu, alert dialog box, toast and toast customization. Now menu, there are various menus available in Android. Option menu, it's a primary collection of menu items for an activity which appears when the user touches the menu button. Context menu, it is a floating list of menu items that appears when the user touch and hold a view that's registered to provide a context menu. Sub menu, it's a floating list of menu items that appears when the user touch a menu item that contain a nested menu. Now first option menu. Now option menu is implemented by using the two methods, on options item selected. First one is, which can be written like that, public boolean on options item selected menu item item. Now we can get the ID of the list of items by using the get item ID method, and the layout, the instance of the layout is created by using the relative layout and is equals to relative layout find view by ID r dot ID dot layout name. Now if ID is equals to 0. Now I'm comparing it with the ID. If ID is equals to 0, then set the background color of the menu of the screen relative layout is to the red color. Else if ID, I'm comparing the ID with the value of 1, then relative layout, the instance L dot set background color, color dot blue, it set the background color of the relative layout to the blue. Else L dot set background color, color dot black, else by default it set the background color of the relative layout to the black. Then return super dot on option item selected item. This one method is implemented for programmatically for option menu, and the second one is public boolean on create option menu, in which we can add the items to the menu by using the add method, which contains the group, order ID, item ID and the item name itself, the label which is displayed on the item itself. Now menu.add, and we are providing these four parameters to the add method and adding the items in the menu. Here menu.add, the group is none, so menu.none, then 0 order ID, then 1 item ID and the label of the item, that is red. That means when we click on the red item, then the background color of the relative layout is set to the red. Same way menu.add, menu.none 1 2 and the blue label and the black label. In this way we can add the items to the menu by using the add method with four parameters in the on create option menus method. By using these two methods we can implement the option menu in Android in programmatically way. It appears like this. When we pressing the three dots button, then it will display the option menu with the menu items red, blue and black. When we click on the blue items, it will change the layout, that means the relative layout's color, background color to the blue. When we click on the red item, it will change the relative layout's background color to the red, and when we click the black, it will select the layout color black. Now next topic, alert dialog box. Now how to create an alert dialog box? First of all, an alert dialog is an extension of the dialog class. It is implemented from the dialog class It is capable of constructing most dialog user interfaces, and is suggested to be a dialog type. It will have the following three components: title of the alert dialog box, then the text area where the message is to be displayed for alert message, and it contains the action buttons. It may be of 1, 2, or 3 action buttons. So the alert dialog box, it covers these three components: title, message, and the action buttons. Now, first of all, in activity underscore main.xml file, we can put a one button. Say here it's the show alert dialog box, and in the click event of that show alert dialog box button, we can implement the on click listener for the alert dialog. Now, for that, in Java file, we create an instance of the button find view by id r.id.button1. So we can find the button by using the find view by id. Now button btn.set on click listener, in that on click listener method, and the corresponding event handler is a public void on click. In that event handler, we can handle the event for alert dialog box by first of all creating the instance of alert dialog dot builder. For that, builder object is equal to new alert dialog dot builder. Then by using the set message method, we provide the message. Now the instance builder underscore object dot set message, are you sure want to quit? And here we are putting the message to the alert dialog box. And then for action buttons, we are putting here the two buttons, set positive button and set negative button. So the instance of the alert dialog dot builder, that is of builder underscore obj dot set positive button having the label yes, and a new dialog interface dot on click listener. And in that on click event handler, we are just writing the finish method. That means when the message alert dialog message is displayed, are you sure want to quit, and if we are putting if we are clicking on the yes button, then it will finish the activity. Means we are finishing from that current window, from current activity. And if we are clicking on the wait button, say that we have to writing in the code of the set negative button, key builder underscore obj dot set negative button wait new dialog interface on click listener and the corresponding event handler on click, in which we are executing the toast message, okay, activity will continue. That means when we are putting on the wait button, that means the toast having that okay activity will continue will be displayed. And then we are showing the alert dialog dot builder, show the alert dialog box. It will look like this. Are you sure want to quit? The message is displayed like that. And if we are clicking on the yes button, then it will quit the current activity. If we are clicking on the wait button, then the corresponding toast message is displayed, continuing the current activity. Now, next topic, Android Toast. Now, Android Toast can be used to display information for the short period of time. Toast contains a message to be displayed quickly, and it disappears after some time according to the time specified. The android.widget.toast class, it is a subclass of java.language.object class where the toast is appear. You can also create custom toast. That means the customization of toast is also possible. Now this is an example of toast message. Toast.makeText. MakeText is a method of the toast for specifying the toast message. Here the first argument in that MakeText method is a get application context. That means it returns the instance of the context. And the second argument, that is the message itself, the message that you want to display by using the toast that you have to write here. And the third argument is a test. Toast.length short or length long, the particular duration of time the toast will appear, and after that it becomes disappear. So these are the three arguments of the make text method of the toast. And the second method is the show method. It will show the toast. Or another way, you are creating an instance of the toast class, like that toast t is equal to toast.makeText and specifying the three arguments of that toast class. And then after that, you have to show the toast by using the toast instance dot show method. Any one of the way you can display the toast. Second, another example here, the toast message, okay, hello java point, java t point is displayed. For that, the toast dot make text get application context. Then the message itself, here we want to display hello java t point, and the third argument duration, time duration, toast dot length short, and dot show method which display the toast. Otherwise toast will be created but not shown, so we specify the show method for showing the toast, for displaying the toast. This is the output, how the toast will appear like that, hello java t point. It's the toast message. Now, how to customize the toast message? For that, we are using the various methods for customizing the toast. For example, here in the previous example, you seen that the toast will be appear by default on the bottom of the screen. If you want to set the position of the toast, then by using the set gravity method, you can customize the toast by specifying the particular position of the displaying of the toast. Say, for example, if your toast is an instance of the toast class, say small toast dot set gravity method, and in the argument of the gravity method, gravity dot center vertical means we are putting the toast in the center vertical position. And here the last two parameter 0 0, they are the x offset and y directional offset, means from center vertical, if we are moving the toast to somewhat in the xy coordinate direction, then at that time we are specifying that coordinates here. Here we are only putting the toast only to the center vertical direction. So we are providing the x and y offset to the zero value. So here, using the set gravity method, gravity dot center vertical, we are putting the toast in the center vertical position, and then displaying the toast by using the toast dot show method. So here our toast is appear to the center of the screen. In this way, we are customizing our toast. Like this, this way the toast is appear to the center of the screen, vertical center. So it's a message that to be displayed in the toast is that, like, my custom toast in center of the screen. So this is a one of the kind of the customization of toast by setting up the positioning of the toast. Thank you for watching and listening.